then we owe it to each other to step away. And so that's what we're doing.
Katie Thurston breaks her silence after Blake split on Instagram, and we have all of the details. Hey guys, and welcome back to another Shared News. We've got all the tea you need to know on Katie and Blake and how they're doing post-breakup. But before we get into it, make sure you guys are subscribed to our channel and ring the bell so you never miss out on any future videos. As always, I'm your host, Zachary Reality, and Katie Thurston is opening up and checking in on Instagram since the post Blake split and letting everyone know what is going on, what really went down. Katie wanted to take the time to make a video and thank everyone who sent her love in regards to her recent breakup with Blake. The couple got engaged on The Bachelorette earlier this summer, and unfortunately, it did not work as they announced their breakup via mutual statement on Instagram last week. Katie stayed silent on Instagram for a few days, but I did see that she went to the beach to kind of clear her head, so that is amazing. However, she got back on Instagram just a couple days later, where she wanted to make a video talking to all of her followers.
People are like, well, what really happened? What's the big thing that happened with Katie and Blake? And it's like, we were together for 6 months. Blake and I are very level-headed and mature, and we communicate very well on our thoughts. And we just both knew, like, if this is how our first 6 months was as a couple, going forward, it was going to not be in our best interest for our happiness to stay together. And so we, you know, as mentioned, mutually decided to part our ways, but we still stay in touch. We still support each other. Nothing but love and respect, truly.
The distance of Blake living in Canada and Katie being in San Diego probably played a bit of a factor, but ultimately the couple just knew that it wasn't meant to be. And Katie also wanted to address the sincerity of it all, as many Bachelor fans have been questioning her season's authenticity, so much so that she even lost thousands of followers since the breakup. Katie says, people break up, people get divorced, not all relationships last, and that's just life. They also wanted to make it work, but Katie is excited to share her new journey and new upcoming ventures as she has been pursuing a career in stand-up comedy. I think where a lot of the inauthenticity possibly comes from the fans, why they're thinking that is because Katie did decide that she wanted to move to San Diego while her season was still airing. She tweeted about looking for apartments. And I think a lot of us were like, well, if you're getting engaged, wouldn't it make sense that you moved in with your fiance or maybe moved closer? Because going from Seattle, Washington, where she lived at the time, was probably closer to Canada where Blake lived. Her going to San Diego was definitely a farther plane ride. So her moving to San Diego definitely seemed like maybe that was a sign that they didn't necessarily have plans to stay together for the long haul. I think that's kind of why a lot of fans are questioning things. Or maybe Blake was possibly considering moving to San Diego. I do want to point out that Blake and Katie doing the long distance thing is very different than grocery store Joe and Serena, who also live in two different countries, because where Joe is in Chicago is only an hour flight to Toronto, which is where Serena is. Blake is on the complete opposite coast as Katie, who is in San Diego, so it's definitely more of a factor in regards to the distance. And I guess the relationship really couldn't work out, and I don't know how real it was for them. They did get engaged on TV, but it still kind of felt like they never were talking about plans to move in together or to move closer. When they were doing all their post-show interviews after The Bachelorette wrapped, they were never talking about like how they were gonna make it work. They just said they were going to figure it out. And here we are a few months after that, and the relationship didn't work out. Blake also wanted to give updates to his fans as well. He took to Instagram to post pictures walking his dogs with his mom, and Blake writes, "When times are really tough and things just aren't going the way you had hoped, it's always the same gang that gets you back on your feet," talking about his dogs and his mom. "Feels good to start getting back into the swing of things." So it seems like Blake is doing okay and he is moving on, and he is not showing up on Michelle's season, contrary to popular belief. That meme has been floating around everywhere. Will we see Blake in Bachelor in Paradise next year? Possibly. Could Katie return to Bachelor Nation? Possibly. But it seems like the two of them are moving on and they still wish the best for each other. Let us know what you guys think in the comments below. How authentic do you think their engagement and their relationship was? couples just don't work out. Clearly they were just one of the couples, but was there more to it? Let us know in the comments and make sure you guys are subscribed to our channel and ring the bell so you never miss out on any future videos. As always, I'm your host, Zachary Reality. You guys can follow me down below. Come talk all things Bachelor with me. Thank you guys for watching. That's all we have, and we will catch you next time. See you later.